This is part 8 of a series on XGBoost. In this video, we will look at the Weighted Quantile Sketch algorithm. This video was produced in Korean and translated into English, and my voice was produced through AI text-to-speech. In the last video, we looked at the approximate algorithm and briefly implemented the code to see its effects. In this video, we will take a look at the weighted quantile sketch algorithm and see how it works by implementing it using the XGBoost library. Let's take a look at what's in section 3.3 of the paper. In the approximate algorithm we looked at in the last video, each bucket contained the same number of data points. For regression using mean squared error, h is 1 and the sum of h is the number of data points. If we split the data into 5 buckets, each bucket will contain n-fifth of the data. All data points have a weight of 1. So we can think of h as the weights for the data points. This is the quantile sketch algorithm. A sketch algorithm, in short, is about calculating something in parallel on small sets of data, and then combining the results to get an approximate final output for a large data set. For classification, binary cross-entropy is used. So h is not 1, but the value calculated by this formula. Therefore, the weights h are not constant for all data points. In this case, the data is not split into buckets of equal size, but instead is split into buckets where the sum of h is equal or similar. This is the weighted quantile sketch algorithm. It can handle weighted data. We have weighted data as shown below. K is the feature number and x are the kth feature values. And h is the weight for each data point. Our goal is to find the split point candidates such that the sum of h is the same or similar in each bucket. Split the kth feature data points into m buckets. And we define the normalized rank function as follows. The feature values x sorted in ascending order are as follows. If this point is z, then the rank of z is defined like this. The denominator is the sum of h over all data points, and the numerator is the sum of h over the data points less than z. It represents the proportion of the sum of h. If the rank is 0.5, it represents the median value. We call this the 50% quantile, or the 50th percentile. Now let's mark the split point candidates as follows. The candidates SK range from 1 to M. The total number of data points is N. The difference between the rank of SKJ and the rank of SKJ plus 1 is this part. Buckets are created where the absolute value of the difference is less than epsilon. The first SK value is the smallest X value. This is because X is sorted in ascending order. And the last SK value is the largest X value. Now let's look at the data on the right. There are two features X and one target Y. After the third iteration, we want to find the optimal split point for the fourth iteration. And the predicted probability in the third iteration is like this. H is the value calculated using the formula above. The feature X vector and the H vector are uppercase D1, shown on the left. The closer the predicted probability Y hat is to 0 or 1, the smaller the H value. On the other hand, the closer the predicted probability Y hat is to 0.5, the larger the H value. When Y hat is 0 or 1, H is 0. And when Y hat is 0.5, H is the largest at 0.25. If the predicted probability is close to 1 or 0, the prediction is confident enough, and the data point is given small weight. On the other hand, if the predicted probability is close to 0.5, the prediction is not confident, and the data point is given higher weight. When the X1s sorted in ascending order are like this, SK are as follows. Split the data points into a total of M buckets. Again, the sum of H in each bucket is the same. And the process of finding the best split point is the same as the approximate algorithm seen in the previous video. Let's look at why H can be used as the weights for data points. First, let's look at the regularized learning objective function presented in equation 3 of the paper. This is a quadratic approximation of the Taylor expansion. And the second and third terms are the regularized terms. This equation can be rewritten as follows. Taking this out of parentheses, we can rewrite it as follows. We can write w squared here, and we can rewrite the gw like this. And we will write the regularized terms as omega w. This equation can then be expressed as a perfect square as follows. Here the first term can be written like this. And the second term is independent of w, so it can be written as a constant. This expression is equivalent to the weighted squared loss function. The loss function of the weighted linear regression covered in the linear regression video is as follows. Calculating the squared loss as the difference between the predicted values and the actual labels multiplied by the weights W is the loss function of the WLR. The output value W corresponds to Y hat, and this part corresponds to the label. And if H is considered a weight, both expressions are the same form. Therefore, H can be used as the weights for the data points. This time, we will implement the weighted quantile sketch algorithm using the XGB classifier of the XGBoost library. The data we will use is like this. This is for binary classification. We generated 500,000 data points. We then split it into training and test data. The total number of trees is set to 200, and the depth of each tree is set to 5. The learning rate, eta, the regularization constant, lambda, and the pruning constant, gamma, are set as follows. And the epsilon is set to 0.03, resulting in 33 buckets. The number of buckets is 1 over epsilon. Let's look at the XGB classifier parameters related to the weighted quantile sketch. There are three types of the tree method parameter: exact, approx, and hist. The first represents the exact greedy algorithm, and the second represents the approximate algorithm. The third is about the histogram-based algorithm. We will take a closer look at this later in the Light GBM video. According to this document, setting the tree method to approx will cause Hessian to be used as weights while sketching. That is, we use H of this equation below as the weights. So if we set the tree method to approx, it will work as the weighted quantile sketch algorithm. And according to this document, the sketch eps parameter, which stands for the epsilon, has been replaced by maxbin. Here we will use the tree method and maxbin parameters. And in the formula for calculating gain, lambda on the left means the lambda in this formula, and gamma means the gamma in this formula. Let's first perform the classification using the exact greedy algorithm. Create a model using the XGBC classifier. Set the basic parameters and set the tree method to exact. We fit this model to the training data and measure the accuracy by predicting the class of the test data. And we check the accuracy and the process execution time. Next, let's perform the classification using the weighted quantile sketch algorithm. Create a model with the XGB classifier and set the max bin and the tree method parameters like this. The max bin means the number of buckets. Set this to 1 over epsilon. If the tree method is set to hist, the max bin means the number of bins in the histogram. We then fit this model to the training data and measure the accuracy by predicting the class of the test data. And we check the accuracy and running time. The results are as follows. For the exact greedy algorithm, the accuracy is 0.961. The running time is 9.22 seconds. For the weighted quantile sketch algorithm, the accuracy is 0.96. It took 1.99 seconds to run. The accuracy is similar, but the running time is much shorter. Run it one more time. The accuracy is the same, but the execution time is this short. This is the effect of the weighted quantile sketch algorithm. Let's try to run this code. The code is now running. It will take about 9 to 10 seconds. The results came out like this. The accuracy of the exact greedy algorithm and the weighted quantile sketch algorithm is similar, but the execution time is significantly reduced. In this video, we looked at the weighted quantile sketch algorithm and implemented it using the XGBoost library. In the next video, we will look at the sparsity-aware algorithm. And finally, let's analyze the Santander Bank's customer transaction prediction data using XGBoost library.